It's only fair. There's gotta be some butterflies somewhere. Wanna share, cause I like you, but that's not enough. So if you will, please fall in love with me. Oh, do me a favor. Can your heart rate rise a little? Do me a favor. Can your heart rate rise a little? To fall in love with me, you see, I'm trying. I know you know that I like you, but that's not enough. So if you will please fall in love, I think it's only fair. There's gotta be some butterfly somewhere. Wanna share, cause I like you, but that's not enough. So if you will please fall in love, oh, I like you, but that's not enough. So if you will please fall in love.
Tonight. I'm so ready. welcome my small but mighty band. Yeah. Okay. So this is Will. He plays violin. This is Sophie. She plays cello. Tiny, just three people. But we have some great backing singers, so. I would love for you to help me out in this next one.
She knows this feeling all too well. She feels her heart begins to swell. And some stranger, you have made her insides turn to jelly. She wants to dance around the room.
Dramatic, which is me to a T. And the one after that is about a boy who I don't know anymore. Oh dear. Woo! Okay. Let's try.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Alright. That's enough happiness. When you come to a dodie concert, or at least you do now. It gets sad from like here on out. I'm sorry. I don't know why, I just love writing sad songs. Although this song might be a nice song, you know, it might be a sweet little love song. Who knows? Or it could be a codependent, unhealthy, maybe manipulative relationship. This is a song about facing someone who I thought I might have to say goodbye to. And I'd said goodbye to a lot of people who knew me intimately and who I loved so much. And I couldn't figure out why this was happening. I don't know, I just wanted to hold on to a lot of them. I didn't know what they were called. They were like people who knew me intimately. It wasn't just people who I was in a relationship. It was people who I was friends with, who I loved. I couldn't figure out a name for them. Found out a name for them. I was sick of losing them. think the lesson from this song is that I think it's very healthy and important to learn when to let go of something that's damaging you or that isn't right anymore, isn't fit well. It's okay to say goodbye and to move on. But I think it's equally as important to hold on to something that you know is worth fighting for. So this is me doing it. This next song is a little difficult to talk about. which is why I only really talk about it in song form, but I'll try and describe a little bit about what it's about. So over the past few years, I have met a lot of people who know me, and who follow me, and who like me, and they might say something like, "You are the only reason why I'm here." And I go, so much pressure, oh my gosh, okay, thank you, okay, all right. And then I'll meet someone else, and they'll say something similar, and it's like, I'm taking all of this stuff, and it's wonderful, but also at the same time, it's so much to carry, and I'm like, oh, wow, 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 wow. And then there's also a side online where people like to talk about me and like to disagree with what I'm doing or who I'm hanging with, or I don't know, what I wear, I don't know, whatever. Anyway, so it just feels like a lot of things to carry, and I'm just being slowly squashed by everything. It's okay. At one point, I felt very overwhelmed by all of this, and I didn't know how to talk about it, because obviously I'm so fucking grateful, and I love my community. I think it's wonderful. Clearly, obviously, it's great. I needed a way to explore just how much it was, and I think I found a way, and this is it. This next one is also sad. So, I wrote this song again a few years ago, but it was at a time when I was feeling very lost. I was developing this weird mental health condition. It's called derealization. It basically means a little woof. Yeah, spaced out. So at that time, I was feeling very lost. I kept looking towards the past for my happiness because I remembered when everything was so vivid and so cool and so perfect and great, and I had no mental health problems and it was wonderful. And then I kept looking towards the future because I was like, then it'll all be okay again, and this will be fixed and this will be fixed, and that means I'll be happy again. And I was just reaching around for every moment that wasn't this one right now, which isn't a very good way to live because then you're not really living at all, are you? Thankfully, I've figured out a better way of dealing with it, and I'm feeling all right at the moment, but we'll get into that. But this was written at a very dark time, but I hope it's proof that you can make something nice and beautiful out of something painful.
Thank you.
wrote this song in a very dark time. And as I was saying earlier, I genuinely do feel a lot better at the moment. But, you know, as someone who struggles with mental health, I'm sure there will be a day when I feel like absolute crap again and I'll be down at rock bottom like, oh no. But I've learned something with my years of my rollercoastering is that you will always come back up again. You will always feel better again. And I am living proof that I promise if you are at rock bottom, you will come up and you will feel okay again. And I wrote this next song after all of those dark months, and for a friend who was also at rock bottom, I wanted to prove to him and to show him that I knew what was going on and that it will be okay again. So this is for anyone who is in that dark place. Listen closely.
I got a secret for the mad. In a little bit of time it won't hurt so bad.
Yay! Yeah! So happy from now on. So this is my last song. And it's about how fun and good life is. So good. All right, let's do that.
Colorful messages.
you're going to need some help.
Okay, slow down. This is my last song. It's going in the middle.
I like you, and I loved him. We could all be the best kind of friends. You said.